The Coupe de Escrivá football tournament in Pan-Atlantic Universtiy is back for her fourth season.
A lot of time and effort have been put into preparation this season. The groundskeepers, the officials, the coaches and the fans are all ready. The entire university campus sits in anticipation. The players are getting ready for the task at hand. Training up to 5 days in a week. Coupe de Escrivá elevates the game that we love, the game of football.
Yeah, he wants to have this unbeaten run.
To different people, coupe, as it's commonly called, means different things.
Coupe de Escrivá. Intense. One word for it is actually intense.
Coupe de Escrivá basically sums up my second semester.
A very dramatic and emotional tournament, especially for guys.
Coupe de Escrivá, it's a soccer competition, I understand, you know, put together by the students in honor of Sainte Maria Escrivá, the founder of Opus Dei.
When you see the passion, the fire behind the eyes of these guys,
a way to actually make boys showcase their footballing talent.
Yes, it's just a university league. I mean, this is our own Premier League. This is our own Champions League.
It's basically a football competition which allows different teams to compete for the ultimate trophy.
Coupe de Escrivá started up as a football competition among students, but eventually we are beginning to showcase some aspects of the PAU brand in it. It's a very interesting tournament that brings students together. It's one of those activities, you know, that bring lives to campus.
It has been a life-changing experience.
I've never seen a competition that brings everybody in school together.
I'm really looking forward to it this year due to the fact that in 2 years, I've entered the final twice and I've won it once.
When it starts, everybody's excited. Like, even girls actually come out to, like, watch the boys play football.
It helps them to live virtues as well, because right there, we are going to witness the virtue of solidarity, we are going to witness the virtue of empathy, fortitude when you see people fighting to get to the final.
Until recently, I didn't think I understood how seriously I took it until I actually had a dream about it. You can imagine how crazy that is.
If you come together, teamwork actually pays off.
Constantly having to look at tactics as a coach and figure out ways to make your team better, you realize in that moment that you can't have assets.
You train, you work on stuff, and you actually see your progress, you know, show on the field.
Coupe de Escrivá means a lot, man. Last year, we didn't have the best results, but there was team spirit, and I could see, like, potential for the Blue Jays team to move forward.
It's an opportunity for me to express myself through football, and football is something I love.
For us in the media unit of the SMC, the Coupe de Escrivá has come to represent an important aspect of the brand.
I think it brings about this atmosphere of tension and suspense and, you know, entertainment.
It's kind of a warm feeling when guys tell you, oh, my team's going to outperform your team.
You can see the intense rivalry.
The few weeks that the competition will hold for, you actually see people coming together, people that wouldn't, you know, that maybe weren't friends or weren't that close before, but, you know, developing this brotherhood.
In every season of Coupe de Escrivá, different people have different expectations. And this season is no different.
The goal each year is to win. So hopefully, I'm a new team for this season. So hopefully, we're going to win.
For Malcolm, I should score like 3 goals.
This tournament is going to be a fun one. And we just want people to come out and see it and enjoy the football, the game of football.
Bigger and better.
It's so intense that there really isn't any way to actually make a prediction.
With the rebranded logos and the way, like, the hype is going, I feel like Coupe de Escrivá this year is going to be like the best Coupe de Escrivá I've ever seen, especially when my team wins it.
We've lost a great number of great footballers and new sets have come.
Most of the star players I know have either graduated or left, and the few we have are obviously going to be spread out across different teams.
I think this is going to be the most competitive Coupe de Escrivá because I feel teams are more evenly balanced, and then there's a lot of hunger in the year ones as opposed to maybe last year, because I've seen a lot of year ones who are actually really anxious and excited about Coupe de Escrivá.
My expectations are to reach the finals, and whatever happens in the finals, well, happens.
Yes, a lot of star players have gone in the pioneer set, but now new students have come, and people have come with different things to prove.
There are people in year four who have never won it before, and they want to win it before they leave PAU.
I'm not going to go out in a limb and say we'll blow the league away necessarily, but I think we're going to be a tough ask for anybody who comes up against us.
The competition was recently rebranded with the redesigning of the different team logos.
All the logos capture the essence of the team, the essence of their names and everything.
The logos that we've been using for the past 3 years, it's not like there's anything wrong with them. I just felt like maybe they didn't really encapsulate the full identity of the teams. And naturally, it happens all the time. After a level of progression, companies, teams, brands, they rebrand and they bring a new image to properly depict the change. Obviously, the first person to design them, when he designed them, the teams were still very new. So they didn't really have much to go on. But after 3 years, I think that there's enough that has happened now. I went back to the drawing board and I designed the logos from scratch, every single one of them. So I looked at the team names and I tried to understand the identity and also, factor that in with the way they've played over the past 3 seasons.
I like the creativity of TSG Walker's logo.
I love TSG Walker so much. That has been my dream team for 2 years. Even though this year I have to play against them. It's very sad thing, but I think I like their logo best because of the John Walker effect.
Very honest, the last team logo was not really, didn't feel like a logo, like an actual team logo. But this year's logo feels like, I like the concept of it. It looks like, oh, somebody is matching or something. So I think it represents TSG well and our work ethic and what we're trying to achieve here in Coupe de Escrivá, which is to win it every year.
That red color is very strong. It's part of the team's identity. So definitely that was going in the logo. And then Walkers. In the first year of the competition, the Walkers came last. The second year, they actually won the league, but they lost in the final. And the third year, they won the league and they won the final. So if you look at that, over the 3 years, they walked from level to level. And I actually put that in the logo with a man holding a flag. The flag shows that yes, they are proud, they're courageous. That's what the TSG Walkers logo is about. And the star above them shows that they've won the competition.
Fantastic inspiration from Tamilore.
When Erie did the first logos, they were calm because they were like the first ever logos. And they looked authentic at that point. But like the rebranded logos now define what the teams are all about.
The logos this year are way better than the ones of last year. For example, the Blue Jays logo, the logo is a Blue Jay.
I really like the new team logo as well. I'll probably say it's the best of the four.
It's my favorite logo. Not just because I'm a Blue Jays captain, but like the Blue Jays logo looks professional. It actually talks about what the team is about.
I really like it. I thought it looked very professional. It captures exactly what a Blue Jay is.
Blue Jays logo was really cool.
So the designer of the rebranded logos, Tamilore Adeshiyan, he told me about what the Blue Jay actually signifies.
I was in Blue Jays in the first year of this competition, and I know that team has a lot of team spirit, and that goes in line with the bird, with their mascot, the Blue Jay bird. Blue Jays naturally have, they work together as a team. This is actually a powerful bird, and I feel like that should show in the logo.
I feel like that logo right there signifies what we're all about, and I really appreciate what he has done.
Honestly, like, it's something that I'll be proud to rep. Like, I really just like it. It's a big improvement over the last one. I'd say the last one was bad, but you can tell that this one took like a little, probably more effort and time and just attention to detail.
If you look at the previous winners of the competition, like Siroc, CSG and Blue Jays, you see like they have like the stars on their logos. Those stars represent the amount of times you won the competition.
Those new logos that represent these clubs, it's like an injection of new life.
I'm excited about embracing that logo and like going to the pitch knowing that that's our logo.
Logos are really nice and they tell a story about the team. So that speaks more about the history, so it gives more significance to the competition.
I like the solidity of Madiba logo.
It's a castle, it's a rock. They're not afraid of anything, they're solid. They don't have a star above their logo yet. But this season, I'm going to speak from a personal perspective. I'm the captain of Madiba. Hopefully, we'll make it to the final this season. The first time I'll actually win it.
And the upgrade is amazing.
Very good work.
Siroc were the first ever team to win the Coupe de Escrivá. That comes with a bit of royalty, especially within this context. That's why the crown is above the logo. I also got a little inspiration from Real Madrid, and Real Madrid, it has some royalty, in the meaning of the name. The two flags on both sides also show their courage and their strength, and the fact that they're not afraid of anything. The laurel plants on both sides shows the ability to grow and the fertile nature of the team.
If you wear a shirt of any team, like the badge, obviously going to mean something to you as well. So you have to just like try your best and perform for the badge.
The new logos that were developed by Tamilore itself also shows me that he also included some things from he learned from the class, because we had some graphics design class, and so he now used that one to develop the logo, which is for me personally, it's a thing of pride and joy.
Whenever we think about Coupe de Escrivá, some legendary names like Dan, Dureke, Cody,
Eri, Awani, Tony, Austin, Moise,
OKP, Aki, and the rest of them all come to mind. But this season is the first time we're going to be without them.
This season, the competition is going to be run by the current final year students. The board members and the captains of the different teams happen to all be in their final year.
Some of my colleagues in the final year, we are actually trying to like bring this competition like to life.
This season happens to be the first time the pioneer set of PAU is in control of the competition. They just graduated last year, so it means now it's up to us.
Being a captain this year is something different, you know, but I had a little feel of it last year because there were one or two games whereby DRK handed me the captain armband to captain the game, and I felt I did okay. So it kind of prepared me for this.
As a team captain, I have like a lot of work to do, like trying to like organize like my boys together, like to make the team have that team spirit.
It's a different responsibility altogether on the pitch and off the pitch. Off the pitch, you need to show example and you need to be flawless. It's way more responsibility than I've probably ever had, but I believe I should be able to take it on.
I was an assistant captain for Madiba last year, so I captained one or two matches. But this time I'm the main captain of the team, so I expect a challenge, but I expect one that I'll be prepared for.
Coupe de Escrivá is primarily a student-run competition, especially in the aspect of the media.
I've been involved in the media aspect.
It's a pleasure. It's part of my passion. I love capturing emotions, different emotions, especially in the field of sports.
I take videos, I take pictures.
I think it's going to really help me in the future. So I really take this as a duty and responsibility.
It's actually really fun because you're in the game itself. You're not like you're someone waiting and just supporting the team or coming out whenever your team is playing. Sadly, I'm not going to be involved this year. I'm in my final year and I have my project to do, and being on the media team really, really takes a lot of your time and effort and energy and dedication. But then again, I'm looking forward to what the media team this year is going to, you know, put forward.
We have a more, should I say, equipped media team.
So that's really the story of the Coupe de Escrivá, and the story goes on. The story goes on. It continues with this new logos, with this new season. There's a lot that's happened. There's a lot more that's going to happen.
For brand communication, I think the Coupe de Escrivá is going to go a long way to showcase the fact that PAU is also interested in sports. And this is one sporting activity that really brings together almost all the community in Ibeji-Lekki campus.
From a general perspective, it's going to be fun to watch. For the neutrals, it's going to be amazing. Even for the fans of specific teams, they're going to have a good time watching their teams, because every team has actually put a lot of effort into it, so everybody's going to play well.
May the best team win.
Well, Madiba right now are the underdogs, but we hope to
you know, break that in our next game against TSG. TSG.
I'm aware.
We're doing training right now, so I'll get to you later.
quick.
Oh my goodness, you cannot write the script for this, Rob. This is unbelievable stuff. Look at the fierce.